information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network. More and more I realize that the government is completely illegitimate. I mean, I know that. I preach that. It's been usurped by criminals who are openly arming to the teeth against us and training police that real Americans are terrorists. I mean, it's right out of a movie. It's right out of history. And they think a bunch of drones and high-tech weapons are going to scare us. It's pathetic. And they're stealing everything. Like, if we're totally poverty-stricken, they think we won't be able to fight back against them. And then I see the general public who's only half awake. They are in for such a rude awakening. Let's go ahead and go to Howard in California. You're on the air, Howard. Welcome.
Hey, Alex. I got to tell you, I'm in Los Angeles. I own a limousine company that has been basically gutted by the government, Bank of America, and the IRS, et cetera, et cetera. I'm hanging on by the skin of my teeth.
You're not a big globalist insider. They're all exempt.
Yeah,
if you're a little guy trying to actually run, and just like the IRS with any small business, no matter, if you could pay them all the money, they'd come and try to gang rape you.
Exactly. I'm just trying to hang on. I'm actually living out of my RV. That's not bad. The last two landlords have been Israelis, believe it or not, because I'm in Los Angeles. But the worst thing is I finally saw something with my own eyes. One thing to talk about it here, keep talking about it on the radio, etc. I saw this with my own eyes at LAX, Los Angeles Airport. They've built a giant human holding pen. It's quite obvious what it's for. It's for processing people. This thing, they used to park all of our limousines and cars and buses at the eastern end of the north set of runways. There's two sets of runways at LAX. They used to park all of us at the eastern end of the north runway, where the planes would land right over the top of us. They moved us all out of there this past summer, which I thought was strange. And I made the mistake of driving back in there because we had to get a ticket to pick up our clients at the airport. What I saw was, when I pulled in there, and I was followed twice by the cops when I pulled in, I took pictures. I sent them to you, I'll send them again. This thing is, it's a holding pen. It can hold thousands of people. It's right next to the tarmac. There's no buildings, no nothing. It's like a 10 or 12 foot fence with a permanent concrete base around the base of it. And there's two sets of barbed wire on top, basically, in and out. So, you know, there's fences like that all over out the airport area. But this thing has four sets.
They actually have one of those at Bergstrom and at the old airport. And I first reported it was a secret holding pen. But the news said I was a conspiracy theorist, but that it was to hold people during civil unrest. So I'm bad for being right and breaking the news. I don't get an award. I'm bad because I'm right, and it's kooky not to like it. So, you know, we get a lot of email. We miss some of it. What email address did you send it to?
I sent it to writers at your Infowars.
When did you send it?
It's this past month. I can't remember when.
Will you send it again?
I'd love to. These turnstiles, let me describe them. Because you could say, well, it's part of an airport. No. These are those big tubular steel turnstiles. They go in, they don't come back out. There's no way to get back out. There's four sets of them, so there's like 16 turnstiles that go into this thing. And it's like the size of 3 football fields. You can get thousands of people. The thing about it that proves what it is, because there's a, on the fence that goes to the, onto the tarmac, you go straight onto the airport tarmac, where, you know, what kind of security is that? They put a big black gate that you can pull trucks, buses, whatever, into this holding pen. So it's built to move lots of people quickly into this pen, and then move them onto the tarmac. Now, what is that for? You know, except to move people and put them onto aircraft?
No, that's like the Oklahoma City Federal Processing Center. This is actually all in the Emergency Centers Establishment Act, and it's just these creepy crooks, all the stuff with our money they've built against us because they know they're a bunch of crooks. And I tell you what, when I put you on hold, we got a break here, I'm going to give you one of our super secret email addresses, and will you please send it? How soon till you can send it to us?
As soon as I hang up, because I can do it on my phone.
Okay, I'm going to put you on hold and send it to you, but... it's not just my opinion. You can search engine or go to the Google spy system, which they admit they're spying on you now, and you can type in IRS cuts investigators for white-collar crime. And when you read, they mean like 100 millionaires, billionaires, the rich. There's like no investigators. They can do whatever they want on record. And then they put the investigators on small and medium and even teeny tiny. So they got whole offices for like a blue collar guy who owes $1,000. But nothing for all the really rich people. So you got a restaurant, a little car dealership, a limo company, you know, five limos, whatever it is. They are on you. We remember in California, the guy owed 14 cents, so the SWAT team came at the car wash and turned out he paid it. It's just busy work for the little low-level crooks. Yeah, there it is. White-collar crime. It's admitted right there. All right, we'll be right back.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the